Anything But is today at Maya Avenue, Colombo 5, this beautiful Irish restaurant called the Four Leafed Clover, undoubtedly the most popular Irish restaurant in the city of Colombo. My guest today on the show is a young lady who hails from a family of film stars. Her older sisters, Jivarani, Shirani, Janaki, and this is the youngest of the Kurukulasuriya girls, Manik. Manik was once upon a time extremely shy, quiet girl, and now she's made up for all that. She's the most talkative of the Kurukulasuriya girls. Manik, hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi.
Now, you spell your name M-A-N-I-K. So you're Manik or Manik?
I'm Manik. It's pronounced Manik. Why do I do it? Because my parents put the name, and since then they have been writing my name as M-A-N-I-K. Okay? And like different people write it differently. So, doesn't matter.
So, Manik.
Yes.
Manik, take us to your childhood in Panadura, where you first went to Good Shepherd Convent.
Yes.
What was life like at that time? Long time ago.
It was up to grade 7 I was there. Age 7 I was in Panadura. 6 and a half actually, because then I went to the school in
Good
Shepherd Convent.
Life was quiet, life was simple, life was nice.
Very nice, because all relatives and friends, lots of people, and it's not like now, you just run around everywhere. So it was very nice.
So Sangeeta must have been an extremely little girl.
Yeah, right? We garden and we used to play and all these. My whole family was so big, at that time, and so it was very nice. Then I was at Good Shepherd Convent, and then I went to the primary school, the preschool, and then after that they promoted me to grade 2 when I was in grade 1, and then we left
double
to Colombo. Double promotion. Yes.
Good. So, and then you
then came,
came
to Colombo. Then we lived right next door to All Saints down Campbell Place. And from my balcony, I could see through to All Saints church altar.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. So church is just there for you?
Yes.
And then you went to St. Paul's in Agiri?
Yes. That's because when I came to grade 8, I had to choose. I was good in my studies, if you I was not chased out. Actually, the nun had an assembly and she said how they were sorry to leave.
Sister Gloria?
No, sister, that's the second one. She was a foreign lady,
okay.
Sister Ninette. So she told at the
assembly
that she was sorry that all the good girls were leaving and mentioned my name. Anyway, I had to go because I wanted to do science. And of course, so I chose that. There were a few options, but then settled for St. Paul's because I had lots of friends there also. So then came to St. Paul's.
And then Sujata?
Yes, this is because I got involved in movies. I'll tell you that later.
Yeah, we can ask later. Now, basically, the four girls.
Yeah.
Were you scared of them?
I was petted when I was young. I was small,
Spoiled?
My sister.
Spoiled?
Not really spoiled, but I could feel a lot of love because I was the youngest.
Okay.
So, my brother and I were the closest. Yes.
Now, your brother Vivek was extremely strict with you, very, very strict.
Yeah, when we grew up, that is. When we were small, we used to always play together and fight and do all kinds of things.
When
I grew up.
Boyfriend.
You are jumping from childhood to boyfriends.
My teenage years.
Just little things now, not like now. Nowadays, actually, girls are closer to boys than we were ever, as girlfriend and boyfriend, even to think like that. So those days, even if you talk to somebody, you think it's a boyfriend, no? So anyway, I grew up with this friend of mine, my neighbor, her older sister, she was also a friend. She used to read all these, novels that were so romantic, and James Barbara Cartland and tell us all these stories when I was about 8-9 years old. And I grew up this idea that this romance the biggest thing in life, and you do anything for that. So by the time Yeah, just, you know, little things. And we were, they were my home. They were very strict. We were not even allowed to go out with girls for a movie at that time in the afternoon. Or even calls were like anybody.
9:30
like banned, right? 9:30 only with the family. No, I mean, in the morning shows, matinee shows, or anything, we were not allowed.
Hey, you were a beauty queen when you were 13 years old.
Yes.
Tell us that story.
Ah, okay. That's because my friend Heather Jans, she was at St. Paul's with me. And she was a little older than me. She was already in this band, Spitfires, I think. Spitfires.
Akasakale.
Oh, Akasakale. So then they used to have this every week. They had this thing like a sundown.
Sundown, yes, sundown.
So it was from 3 to 7 or something like that. So she used to sing with the band. So I want to see her. So
yeah. I think you were 13 years old.
Yes, I know. I want to just go and see her. It's from 3 o'clock to 7 o'clock or something.
Okay.
So my, no way they wouldn't allow me to go with my friend. So I had to plead with my sister. Shirani was there at that time. So her friends were this Sampath Srinandalochan, if you remember,
his
wife. So they asked my parents, you know, the three of them got together and took me. So when I was there, they had this, every week they used to choose four girls from the audience and choose a winner. So that used to get full coverage in the weekend paper,
yes,
if you remember.
Yes, the weekend
sign. Yeah, so one whole page was given to that.
Black and white?
No, color. The back page was black and white, the cover page was color.
So you won it that day?
That day I won it. And then at the end of the year, with all the girls, girls together. I got, what the was it?
13-year-old beauty queen.
No, when I won the,
yes,
when I won the whole thing, I was 14.
What did your parents say to that?
No, as long as it was with the family and they are like, you know, they were supportive. They were not against it or anything like that. But I think I started too young.
So this 14-year-old Goya beauty queen,
yeah,
from that era was later on to become a Miss Sri Lanka for Miss Universe in our next section. But what was, so then you came into films, and but you were always like a baby, very quiet.
Yes, I was very quiet, I was naive. I would believe anything anybody said. And
what are you now? Compared to what you were then.
Oh my God, I wish I knew. I had the same knowledge of the world as now. I would do things completely differently, but you can't. Only by making, you know, going through life you can learn also. No? Well, anyway, because my sister and my whole family was like very good, nice people. I mean, there was nothing to learn. Even the environment, the people who were close to me. So I didn't have any other knowledge of, you know.
And your parents passed away when you were fairly young. You were 17 when your mother died, and you were about 19 when your father died.
No.
So
20, I think, when my father died. 3 years
later. But the family was the core unit, basically, in your life.
Yeah. So, me being the youngest, I used to sleep with my mother till she got sick. And I couldn't sleep without her. Even if she got up and went, I would cry in the night, you know. I start shouting for her till that age, you know. Then, so when she got sick, I was with her. I looked after her and I slept next to her right throughout 2 years.
So, very much the beautiful daughter. The beautiful daughter.
No, I thought that was the thing to do. There was nothing.
Yes.
I didn't know any other way.
So on that note, we bring sequence X to a close with Manik Kurukulasuriya, the youngest of the Kurukulasuriya girls, mm-hmm, and the Four Leaf Clover escorted by the number 5. In the next sequence, we have what I call it Anang Manang Shat. Little bits of loss of things. Catch you soon.